Bomjon hates Buddha, but he hijacks Buddha because he needs the Buddhist image to recruit people. And then he transforms them to blue monks, but they are not even monks. They are just taking a blue robe, and it's not a spiritual path. It's a cult. The main religion of that cult, religion, is to worship Bomjon as God. There is no other activity apart from worshiping him and reading a few so-called prayers, which are totally empty because they are not keeping those prayers. It's about non-violence and love and Maitri and blah blah blah. But if they worship Bomjon as the embodiment of God, which is totally not a Buddhist concept, because Buddha was actually a kind of nearly atheist teacher, because he was showing the path that we don't need to worship gods. And obviously the Tibetan Buddhism took it to a different form, and finally they again worship gods because it's human. But the original teaching of Buddha was to find God in ourselves, the nirvana in ourselves, through the meditation. And there is not a very difficult path of Buddha. It's meditation of the style of Vipassana, and the teachings, moral teachings, which are, if you read the Dhammapada and you do Vipassana, you get the main core of Buddhism. But Ram Bomjon was misusing Buddha's good name, hijacking his various lineages, and trying to delete Buddhism through recruiting his followers from Buddhism. And he's still trying it. And I mentioned that they are doing still in a low profile, but it will be bigger. Actually, I know the future, but don't ask me now. Okay, please. Just do what I am warning about, and then you will see that it was very important. So you have to stop this destruction of Buddhist temples. And please, I am asking everyone who is watching my videos, don't focus on my person. I am a victim of Bomjon, but I was a follower of Bomjon as well. And I did not reject him because I became a victim. All my devotee friends, ex-devotee friends, know that 1 or 2 years even after the terrible tortures that he did to me, I was still propagating him. So I know it's crazy, but I did not want to reject him just because he did bad to me. You can understand this philosophy if you are a spiritual person. When I started to reject Ram Bomjon was when I saw that he did similar or worse things to other people. And I don't want to boast about this unselfish attitude, because this is just natural to me. I was always thinking about other people, and always other people, other people. And what he did to me, tortures and everything, it's described in my videos. I was long trying to digest that and consider it as kind of personal, individual account with him, which I had to clear out from some kind of past life, which I don't remember. Although I remember most of my past lives, but I don't remember any past life with Bomjon. And there is a reason for that. But let's not go into details. Please don't focus on my person. That was my request. Marichi was his victim, so she is rejecting him. That's why. No. Everyone who knows me from many years knows that I was still brainwashed when I was released from his chains. And when I started to speak out against Bomjon on my websites and later on my videos, it was when I saw that he's doing terrible things to other people. And even more terrible, because he killed his sister. He killed Mr. Moore. He raped Gangamaya, a minor, etc. So these are things which I cannot accept anymore, because it's not about me anymore. And so I am also spiritual, but please don't put me in this category, on that category. Some people think that because I put these shawls on my head that I am Muslim. I'm not Muslim. I don't understand Muslim religion, I must tell you. This is the newest religion of all, and I cannot speak about Muslim religion because I don't understand it. The ancient religions which I understand is Hindu religion, most of all, the most ancient religion, and Jewish religion. And I am not so fitting into Christian religion either, but I am from the Christian culture. So obviously, if you grow up in hearing and seeing all this and visiting temples, and it's also part of our education to know about our history in Europe, so you know about Christianity. And I was trying to find the same spirituality like I found it in yoga in Christianity, but I failed to. So I just I tried it, it didn't work, so I then decided that external religions are not for me. You can believe in external religions as you wish, but not for me. So don't put me, please, that she's Hindu, that's why she speaks again Bomjon. This is what they use usually, the Bomjon's followers. And now they use, she's a Vatican agent, she's a Vatican implant, because every European is a Christian, they think. Actually, I must tell you, if you are Nepali and listening to this video, I have never seen so many Christians, so many very active and very, proselyte Christians than I saw in Nepal. It's true, in every Nepali village you have 5 or 6 churches. This is another thing, that they are not really Christians, but they made like a cult from the Christian philosophy. I don't go into details, but please don't think, if you are Nepali, that we foreigners are all Christians and the only thing we want to convert all Nepal into Christianity. Probably not. If I am wearing Rudrakshas, and I am all the time, I was wearing Tulasi, and I was going to, I was wearing also the Shivaji sign, the 3 lines, because I am a sadhu. So I don't, please put me into that or this category or draw, because I am not this or that. I am just Marichi. I am a yogini. This is the only category where I do belong, because yoga is an inner path. And I was long ago a yogini when I was fooled by Bomjon that he is also a yogi. And I was long ago a yogini when Bomjon was not even born. So this is another thing that Bomjon is trying to spread about me, and he's using his elite followers like Mani Lama, Jas Bhadurbhai Bhuminan Devkota, to spread this about me, Pragyaratna Ghulu, that I came to him like a total ignorant about any spirituality, and that I was searching for enlightenment at his feet. Rubbish. I was not searching for anything, for just a place where I could live in a spiritual community, because of my individual life, difficult life problems in Europe. And plus I was very happy that I found someone who seemed to be on the same path like me, a meditating path, and I wanted to use all my talents and all my abilities and knowledge about yoga to help him and to support him. Everyone knows that I was writing loads of articles to propagate Bomjon. You can find in Google group my articles till today, in the email inboxes of 700-800 people all over the world. So you cannot fake it, you cannot just deny it, that I did have spiritual interest and experiences long before Bomjon. And so I am nothing else than a yogini. I'm not a Christian, not a Buddhist even, and I'm not a Hindu, if you want to put me somewhere. I respect all these religions, and I have a lot of knowledge about all these religions due to the fact that the core of all religions is God, the same God. So obviously, a person who is in connection with the divine, with the divine lineage, that person will understand also the core of Christianity, Judaism, Buddhism, Hinduism. I don't say Muslim, I am sorry for the Muslims, please apologize, I apologize. I don't understand Muslim religion. And I don't understand all the new religions which came after, like Krishna Pranami and Brahma Kumari and millions of others who are actually cults in my eyes. Mm-hmm.